Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. And welcoming all of us again. Welcoming you again. Online today to this Sunday service. Amen. The Lord is good. Hallelujah. I believe He has something great and wonderful for us. Hallelujah. So thank God that He woke us all up this morning to see the light of a new day, a great and wonderful day. In fact, this is the day the Lord has made. We rejoice and be glad in it. Amen. So welcome again and get ready, because I believe God has something for you this morning. Amen. That's something for you. That's something for you. So get your Bibles, get your writing materials, because you may see the need to write. Amen. Praise the Lord. And as the word is going on, please just make your comments. Okay, respond. Receive the word. Receive the word. Let your hallelujah be seen. Let your amen be seen. Amen. Let your comment be seen. Amen. That is how to key into the word. That's how to key into the word. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. Let the angels see that you believe and you are receiving the word. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen. Let us pray. Our blessed Father in heaven, immortal and invisible God, the only wise God, omnipotent, omnipresent, omniscient, we thank you because you are on the throne and you are in every place where your children are gathered together, in their homes, in the office, everywhere, Lord, to connect to this meeting. We thank you because all power belongs to you and that you work in our midst. We thank you in advance for the blessing you have prepared for us. Lord, I yield my spirit, my soul, my body to you. And I ask in the name of the Lord Jesus, let you alone be glorified in today's meeting. Touch somebody, heal the sick, set captives free, encourage those who have been discouraged. Strengthen the weak. Let it be at the end of today's meeting that every soul will have reasons to glorify our God. Thank you once again. I yield my spirit, soul, and body to you. That Lord, you will use me and speak through me. For I say, I have no word of my own, no knowledge, nothing of my own. Everything, O God, belongs to you. And so, Lord, I pray that you honor your word in my mouth, as by your grace I speak as the oracle. Thank you, my God. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Okay, so we're going to continue with last Sunday's message, which we talked about. The title is, He Was in My Shoes. He was in your shoes. Jesus was in our shoes. He was in my shoes, was in your shoes. Amen. Hallelujah. By the way, if this is your first time of connecting with us, I am Pastor Newton Denila. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The Senior Pastor of Grace All Ministries, House of Favor. Hallelujah. Okay. So, Christ was in my shoes. He was in your shoes. And I believe that because He was in our shoes, as it is written, He knows where it is pinching you. He knows where it is pinching us. And He's able to take care of us, able to handle the situation. Because He feels the way we are feeling. He felt it before. He went through all before. Now, but it's important that we look at this from the scripture so that we can be encouraged. Because the things that are written, they are for example, for encouragement, and so on. So, ask for the apostle, because this is something people don't, many times don't take to heart. We just think many times that Satan, you know, was so powerful, and then he was able to kill Jesus. they took him, you know, and anyhow, like that, you know, they crucified him. Well, it's important for you to know that Jesus did not come into this world on his own account. He didn't come by his personal choice. It was the will of God that he came. It was planned by God that through Christ, the whole world will be redeemed, reconciled back again to God. And all that Jesus Christ went through were ordained by God. The sufferings and so on were ordained by God that he had to suffer for us. Hallelujah. Acts 2:22, he said, "You men of Israel, hear this word. Jesus of Nazareth, a man approved of God among you by miracles and wonders and signs, which God did by him in the midst of you, as you yourself also know. He being delivered by the determinate counsel and the foreknowledge of God, you have taken and by wicked hands have crucified and slain." It's not the slaying that is the issue at this point. It's not the crucifixion that is the point we are making here. But the fact is, the fact that God knew, predetermined it. He said by the foreknowledge of God, God knew it, God predetermined it, God planned it. He planned it that Jesus Christ should come to the world to suffer for you and I. So that he was killed was not because Satan was so big or so strong or powerful. No. The Lord Jesus himself said, he said, nobody can take his life unless he personally lays it down. Amen. He said, because the prince of this world cometh and shall find nothing in him. And that is one key word I would like you to take to heart this morning. When the prince of the world comes, let him not find something in you. Make sure, therefore, you don't give the devil any room in your life. Amen. So it was by the determinate counsel and the foreknowledge of God that Christ was taken and crucified. But one good thing is that at the end of the day, God also raised him up from the dead. And as we speak, he's seated at the right hand of majesty on high. He's seated. The Bible says God raised him up from the dead. God highly exalted him and gave him the name that's above every name. That was after the sufferings, after he was crucified, after he went to hell, God raised him up. Amen. God will raise you up. What you are going through, God will take you out of it. Hallelujah. I say, God will take you out of it. God will take you out of it. Now, so what we are looking at is that sometimes, because sometimes when you go through problems, you go through challenges, I know there are problems that you cause by yourself. I know there are problems that the enemy just bring to destroy your life and frustrate the counsel and the plan of God concerning you. But listen to me. Listen to me. In God, your Father does not give you out to the enemy. There is nothing the enemy can do about it. That is why Paul said he was fully persuaded that which has committed to God, God was able to keep, preserve against that day. Anything you give over to God, God is able to keep it. The God that's upholding the universe by the word of his power, the sun, the moon, the stars, the earth, they have not fallen. For your information, you know the earth is moving in space. The sun, the stars, the moon, everything, the planet, they are all moving in space. They have not fallen, they have not collided. It is God that is keeping them suspended by the word of his power. Yet God can uphold the planets. God can uphold you. In fact, the Bible said that he is the Lord that is upholding us with the right hand of his righteousness. So may God go into uphold you. But child of God, make sure you don't open the door for the enemy. Make sure you don't give the devil the room. Amen. To operate in your life. Now, but in the midst of all this, in our existence, our journey in life, sometimes God will allow us to go through challenges. Because Christianity is not the bed of roses. It's not that because you got born again, you will not face challenges. The Bible says those that will live righteously should be ready to face persecution. The enemy will come against you, but child of God, don't need to worry about the plans and the activities of the devils. Because many will be your affliction, but God will surely deliver you from every one of them. You will come out better and stronger. So sometimes God allows us to go through challenges just to prove us, to prove you, and sometimes for you to learn to depend on Him. So God allows certain things to happen to us. They may not be very pleasant, but there's a lesson and there's a reason for it, for God allowing it. For us to learn to depend completely on Him and not on ourselves. So sometimes you find yourself going through certain things. Maybe when you begin to feel too proud of yourself, when you begin to feel too dependent on yourself, sometimes God can allow you to go through certain things for you to know that that you are making it not by your power. You are making it in life, it's not by your strength. Do you understand that? God wants to make you to know that it is Him that is giving you the success that you are experiencing in your life. It is Him that is keeping you alive, and not by your strength, not because you chose to wake up. It's God that made it possible to wake up to see the light of another day today, and by His grace, you will see tomorrow. Hallelujah. So He allows us to go through challenges to prove us, sometimes for us to learn to depend completely on Him and not on ourselves, and also to refine us and make us better people, better children of God. Amen. And in time of such challenges, what you should do is to remember that there were people who have gone through such challenges before. There were people. And as we speak, there are people who are going through the same challenges you are going through. There were people that went through those challenges, they didn't give up, they depended on God, they waited on God, and God showed Himself, and God delivered them. There are people who are going through the same challenges you are going through now. They have not given up. And by the grace of God, God is also going to get them out, because God is faithful. God is faithful. God is faithful because He's not going to allow you to be tempted beyond that which you are able to bear. With the temptation, according to Scripture, is going to make a way of escape for you. Hallelujah. You can write 1 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 13. He said, there is no temptation taking you but such as is common to man. What you are doing is common to everybody. It's common. But God is faithful, who will not suffer you to be tempted above that which you are able, but with the temptation also make a way of escape, that you may be able to bear it. Hallelujah. Child of God, for this reason, we say that this present global COVID pandemic and the financial challenges that the whole world is facing, though they are not caused by God, I say they are not caused by God. COVID-19 is not the handwork of God. The global financial meltdown is not caused by God, but God allowed them. God has allowed them for whatever reason. That I will say, best known to Him. One thing that is clear, which you must take to heart, is the fact that your faith right now is being tested. Our faith, our patience, they are being tested. Your endurance, your power to endure in times of crisis, they are being tested. They are being tested. It's your faith. In times like this, will you give up on God? In times like this, will you be able to stand firm and say, I will not be moved? Child of God, it's your faith, your patience, your power to endure that is going to trial. But I pray that you will not fail. I pray that you don't fail. I pray that you don't give up. Amen. Amen. These problems, these challenges, child of God, they are not to break you. They are not meant to break you. You are a child of God. You are a child of God. I say you are a child. They are not meant to break you. They are not meant to destroy you. But to make you stronger, because by the grace of God, if you don't give up, by the grace of God, at the end of this whole crisis, you will discover in yourself that your faith would have become stronger in God. Your power to endure, your power to, your patience level would have gone higher. Amen. And that is my prayer also for you this morning, that God will grant you the grace to stand firm and not be moved and don't give up. So that this whole crisis will not see your end, but you will see their end. You will see their end by the grace of God. Hallelujah. Remember Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. In the midst of the fire, remember that God was with them when they were thrown into the midst of the fire. Remember what they said to the king, Nebuchadnezzar. If you throw us inside this fire, if you decide not to throw us, we will not worship. That if you do us favor, I say, oh, I'm going to pity this young man. I'm not going to throw them again to the fire. King will not worship you. And if you also decide to throw us inside, be it known to you also that will not worship you either. Why did they say even if the king throw all them, if he throw them inside, they will not worship? Because they knew in themselves that Jehovah God, their father, the God that they serve, will be able to deliver them. Child of God, have that confidence. Have that faith. In the midst of all this crisis that is going on, God is with you. God will deliver you. God will deliver you. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, God will deliver you. Just where he was with Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego in the fiery furnace of fire, so also God is with you right now. You may not be feeling his presence. You may not be seeing him. But God is at work in your life. He's there. He's there. He's in you, because, child of God, to assure yourself that he's there, believe his word. He said he will never leave you nor forsake you. He said even though you walk through the water or you walk through the fire, he will be there with you. He said the water will not overflow you, nor the fire kindle upon you. Fire will not burn you. The water will not overflow you. You will not be drowned. So God is with you to keep you alive, because he said in the days of war, he will save you. And in the days of famine, he will sustain you. Sustaining you may not necessarily mean that you are going to be seeing food every day on your table, but child of God, whatever you eat, you will be satisfied with it. You may even drink just water, just a cup of water. And somebody who have eaten 3 square meals will look at you and say, oh, you look well fed. Remember the same people, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Remember when you were being tried. When the king said they should train up some little children, give them, let them eat of the king's food. But Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, all of them, they said, no, king, we are not going to eat of your meat. But they told him, the eunuch that was assigned to them, that they would rather eat pork. They would eat from the king's table, but at the end of the day, they look better than those who fed from the table of the king. When the grace of God is upon your life, whatever you eat will be nourishment to your body. Amen. So don't quit. Don't give up. Because God is working out something for you. He's working out something better for you. Don't give up. Don't give up. No matter what you are going through right now, don't give up. God is greater, bigger, mightier than whatever you are going through. The scripture said that the word of God, the words of God, are pure. And as silver, they are tried and purified seven times. This word purity and beauty, listen to me, child of God. Sometimes even the gold, in fact, not sometimes, the gold, this gold you see, very expensive gold out there. I said it before sometimes that if someone gives you a pure or refined gold, you may even throw it away. You may say, I don't need it, I don't want it. But that same gold, after they have gone through fire, through the process of refinement or purification, if that same gold you see in the shop and they tell you it costs millions of dollars, and you'll be wondering, can this, is it not the same dirty gold that I rejected? Yes, it's the one you rejected. You rejected it because it has not gone through the process of refinement. It has not gone through the process of purification. And here, the word of God that is pure, the Bible says, as silver tried in fires seven times, so also the word of God has been tried. This word that is powerful, the words of the Lord. So what is happening, child of God, is that we are only going through a process of purification and refinement, just as the word or gold are tried in the fire. Don't give up. I say, don't give up. Don't give up. Don't let the enemy talk you out. Don't let the enemy discourage. Don't even listen to the enemy to give you an easy way out of it, so that you don't become like what they call half-baked bread. Half-baked, you are not completely refined. You are not completely purified. Hold on to God. Stay. Hold on to God. Hold on to God. Keep trusting Him. Keep believing Him. Painfully convinced that God is at work in you. He said, it is He that's at work in you, both to will and to do His good pleasure. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Child of God, another reason, what I'm trying to say to you is that God is not ignorant of what is going on. And God is not ignorant of what you are experiencing in your life, even before the coronavirus pandemic. Because some have been going through challenges even before the pandemic. The pandemic also has just got to compound the problems. But listen, whether you have been going through challenges before the pandemic, or you started going through it, or just yet, listen to me. God is aware. Nothing takes our God by surprise. He said, hell and destruction are open before His eyes. The enemy cannot take God by surprise in your life. So believe that God will not give you over to the will of the enemy to terminate your life and make the problem see your end. No, you will see the end of the problem. You will see the end of the challenges. It doesn't matter what the enemy is doing. Child of God, God knew that the children of Israel will be in the land of bondage for 407 years. He said that to Abraham. But according to scripture, he said he also bring them out after 470 years in bondage. He God said it before Isaac was born. Before Isaac gave birth. Isaac gave birth to Jacob, and Jacob gave birth to his children. Because it was in the days of Jacob and his children that that word was fulfilled, that they went into Egypt to sojourn in a strange land according to the word of God. Hallelujah. You can write that in Genesis, write Genesis chapter 15, verses 12 to 16. He said, and when the sun was going down, a deep sleep fell upon Abraham, and lo, an horror of great darkness fell upon him. And he said unto Abraham, that is, the Lord said unto Abraham, Abraham, know of a surety that thy seed shall be a stranger in a land that is not theirs, and shall serve them, and they shall afflict them 400 years. And also that nation whom they shall serve will I judge. That is Egypt. Will I judge? And afterwards shall they come out with great substance. You are coming out with great substance. You are coming out better. You are coming out stronger by the grace of God. And thou shalt go to thy fathers in peace, and thou shalt be buried in good old age. But in the fourth generation, listen now, but in the fourth generation they shall come out hither, for the iniquity of the Amorites is not yet full. The iniquity of the Amorites is not yet full. So everything is just according to God's plan. But you see, this word that God gave to Abraham was not fulfilled until the days of Jacob. And when the children of Israel, that the children of Jacob, when they sold their brother Joseph into Egypt, I mean to the, that they, of course, they sold them to the Midianites, the merchants. Little did they know that they were working out, fulfilling the plan and purpose of God. Little did they know. For them, they thought they had sold Joseph, and that was going to be the end of the life of Joseph. But it wasn't. But God was on the throne. The plan and purpose of God will be fulfilled. For Joseph will tell his brethren, Genesis 15, 19 and 20, he said, and Joseph said unto them, fear not, for am I in the place of God? Child of God, are you in the place of God? The enemy would have brought these problems and troubles and challenges to you. The question is, are you where God wants you to be? Verse 20. But as for you, Joseph speaking to his brethren, you thought evil against me, but God meant it unto good, to bring to pass as it is this day, to save much people alive. And that was what happened. Are you here? God can't be taken by surprise. What is important is that, is God with you? That's what is important. Is God with you? If God is with you, what you should be sure of, that God is with you. Child of God, listen to me. Let the comfort of scriptures comfort your heart. Let the Holy Ghost comfort you. Amen. God is working on something. The enemy shall be destroyed. Listen to me. Through your experience, this experience, you are going to come to a place where you'll be able to counsel people. You are able to go comfort people. Only be sure that you learn the lesson that God wants you to learn. Look at Joseph, Genesis chapter 31. And Joseph was brought down to Egypt, And Potiphar, an officer of Pharaoh, captain of the guard, an Egyptian, brought him on the hand, bought him on the hands of the Ishmaelites. That's right, the Ishmaelites were the people they sold him to. The Ishmaelites, which had brought him down thither. And the Lord was with Joseph. The Lord was with Joseph. The Lord is with you. The Lord is with you. The Lord is with you. And may he never give up on you. And may you also never give up on God. And the Lord was with Joseph. And he was a prosperous man. And he was in the house of his master, the Egyptian. And his master saw that the Lord was with him. And that the Lord made all that he did to prosper in his hand. Child of God, God is with you. Hallelujah. So it was a plan of God that Joseph should end up in Egypt. But when the brothers were selling him, they didn't know they were fulfilling God's plan. If the devil had known that what he's doing right now to you, we're going to bring glory to God at the end of the day, he will not do it. But listen to me, your life, your experience you are going through today will bring glory to God. You'll bring glory to God. Your enemies will not only be destroyed, but those human beings who have laughed at you because of what you are suffering, by the time God will turn things around in your life, the same people are going to come and rejoice with you. The same people are going to come and look for help in your hand. Because the children of Israel that sold Joseph out, they were the same people that came to bow before him. Those that have been laughing at you today, mocking you today, making gestures today, they shall come to bow before you by the grace of God. Hallelujah. Just keep strong. Remain strong in the Lord and don't give up. Amen. Our Lord Jesus Christ was tempted according to Matthew chapter 4, verses 1 to 11. But listen to me, when we talk about Jesus being tempted, it was not as though Satan just took him and began to tempt him. What I'm trying to make you understand is that God has hand in the things you are going through. Apart from those that you yourself use your hand to create cause. So don't open the door for the enemy. Amen. But if the enemy comes to try you, or you need somebody to come and try you, leave yourself. Don't worry yourself. Don't bother yourself. Our Lord Jesus Christ was led by God, the Spirit of God, and not the devil. He was led by the Spirit of God into the wilderness to be tempted. The Bible said for 40 days, he was tempted, 40 days. He fasted for 40 days, 40 nights. And listen to me, temptation didn't come during those periods. Satan waited until he was hungry. Because you know a hungry man, for 40 days dry fasting, when you finish your fast, you want to just see anything you want to see, anything you see you want to eat to break your fast. That is when Satan came. When he had finished fasting, the devil now came to tempt him to do what ordinarily he would have been able to do, which he can do, but the devil want, all that the devil was looking for was obedience to him. For Jesus to obey him, the devil. Because the scripture said, to whom you yield yourself to obey, to him you have become a servant. He wanted Jesus to become a servant just the way Adam and Eve became servants of the devil, or children of the devil, because they sold the authority that God gave to them to the devil by obeying the devil to do what God asked them not to do. Are you here? So when he was hungry, the devil came and began to tempt him. If you know you are a son of God, command this stone to become bread. Because the devil knew he was hungry. But the Lord Jesus Christ knew the word of God that said, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds out of the mouth of God. He shut up the mouth. May you receive grace to shut up the mouth of the devil when he brings you to the place of temptation, or when you are in the place of temptation. May you receive grace to shut up the mouth of the devil. Child of God, in all the temptation Jesus Christ went through, food, pride, are you here? All the temptations that Adam and Eve, Adam, what did you call it? Not even Eve, Adam went through. Are you here? That Adam failed, Jesus Christ passed every one of them. Talking about tempting, temptation has to do with the loss of the eyes, the loss of the flesh, which has to do with food, the pride of life. Are you here? Adam went to others. They saw the food was good for food. They saw the food was good for food. Was one to make somebody wise and all those stuff. Jesus passed it. May you find grace to pass the temptations. May you receive grace not to fall. May you receive grace not to give up. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So, Jesus was tempted, but it was God that led him there. That's the point I want you to understand. God led him there to be tempted. Thank you, Jesus. Abraham also was tempted to give his only son Isaac. Because child of God, you have to prove to God, you have to prove to God that you are serving him, you are worshiping him, not because things are good. The time to prove to God that you are with him is when things are difficult. Yes. It's not when things are working out for you, you are making money, you know, you are not sick, you don't have any problem in the court or police or with police or anything, then you'll be jumping and thinking that that's how life is. Listen, it is in the time of temptation, in the times of challenges, that is when champions are made. That is when you have to prove to God that yes, you are not just serving him because things are working out well for you. You are serving him because you believe in his ability to save, to deliver, to restore. Amen. Abraham was tempted. But when God saw that Abraham will not withhold anything from him, because Abraham was ready to kill his son, he was ready. But the same Abraham said, the Bible said that Abraham also received a son in a figure. In other words, Abraham, he just trusted in the power of God. It was God that gave him the son. He trusted that God also gave him the son in first, but he also gave him to raise up the son back to life. So the Bible said, even though he was going to kill his son, he received his son in a figure. In other words, for him, I'm going to kill this young man, sacrifice to God, but I'm not going back without him. I will kill him, but God is going to raise him up and I see him back to my son. That's the faith. So when Abraham was going to kill his son, God saw that Abraham was ready to do anything. And God stopped him and now made a provision with a ram in the place of Isaac. May God make a way for you too. May God make a way for you. Hallelujah. Child of God, the children of Israel were also tried and proved several times. They were tried and proved, the children of Israel, many times. And those who failed and died were those who chose not to believe. They chose not to believe and obey God after all that God did before their eyes. After God did before their eyes, they saw the miracles before. They saw the parting of the Red Sea and all those stuff. They saw the judgment of God upon the children of Egypt, upon the Egyptians. They saw all that. They experienced light when there was darkness in Egypt. They experienced light in Goshen. How can you, after seeing all these things, then you still begin to doubt God? Not because you were tempted to be thirsty, no water, no food for how many weeks, how many days? Those were the ones that died. Child of God, you cannot tell me that God has not done something for you since you gave your life to Christ. The fact that you are breathing, if at all, no miracle, you have not acted anything, the fact that you are breathing today, this breath of life, you didn't buy it from the store. It's God that gave you that breath, that made you to live, is enough miracle. Believe that this God has given you this breath, that this God is going to give you the breath to breathe, and you will not die before your time. And the plan and the purpose of God that not shall be fulfilled in your life. Amen. Deuteronomy chapter 8, verses 2 and 3. He said, and thou shalt remember all the way which the Lord thy God led thee these 40 years in the wilderness. To do what? To humble thee. Wilderness time is not the best of life. In fact, what is going on right now in the world is like we are going through the wilderness. We are going through the wilderness. Going through the wilderness. But God is with us. As God was with them, so God also is with us. Now, he said what? God led you through the wilderness to humble thee and to prove thee, to know what is in thy heart. It's unfortunate that some people, since the pandemic or the lockdown or whatever, some people have not carried their Bible. Some people are not even able to connect online with the churches or the ministries where they belong. Their prayer, in fact, I would say some people have forgotten Christianity. To them, thank God, but no longer going to church. Some of them are looking for a way to get out of their financial crisis, their problems. They are doing things that are contrary to the will of God. These are the same people that we expecting that God will deliver them. I pray for such people that God should have mercy and draw them back before the enemy will take advantage of them. Amen. He said to prove thee, to know what was in thy heart, whether thou wouldest keep his commandment or no. Verse 3. And he humbled thee and suffered thee to hunger. God is allowing people to go hungry today. He's permitting it. I saw one video yesterday, in fact, my heart was melted. Young boy, somebody showed it on I saw it on Facebook. A young boy, you know, picking up rubbish to eat because he said they have no food. Child of God, it's a pity. People are going through terrible conditions. But God is still alive and God is there. God is watching. Anything you can do to help somebody, please do it. I say whatever you can do to help somebody around you that is going through difficulty, if you have, please do. Amen. He says, suffer thee to hunger, and he fed thee with manna which thou knewest not, neither did thy fathers know, that he might make thee to know that man doth not live by bread only. Did you see that? Even though they were going through hunger, God still fed them with manna. Child of God. The reason God said he did this was to make them to know that man does not live by bread, only bread. That rice, that beans, that salad, that cake, that those things you cherish so much. He said God said man does not live by those things only, but by what? But by every word that proceeded out of the mouth of the Lord doth man live. Child of God, if there's any time for you to get closer to the word of God, if there's any time for you to get closer to God to increase your faith, it is now. It is now. It is now. You need the word to survive. You need the word of God to live. Though he didn't say man shall not eat by bread, man shall not eat bread at all. God will still provide you with bread. It may not be as the normal one. It may not be like you during this period, the pandemic, during this lockdown or whatever. Listen to me. It may not be as it used to be. But child of God, God will sustain you. I said to you, even if it is water you drink, God will make sure that that water keeps you strong, keeps you fresh. Amen. Hallelujah. Child of God, one of the things you must know, like we said at the beginning, because Jesus was in your shoes. He has gone through all this. What the children of Israel were going through, hunger, Jesus Christ suffered it. And the Bible said he is our intercessor, he's our high priest. He's our high priest in the presence of the Lord. Doing what? Making intercessions for us. Because he had gone through what we are going through, because he was in our shoes, he is able to present your prayers now before the Father according to the will of God, because he has gone through it. He has gone through it. He knows what it means to suffer hunger. He knows what it means to be tempted. Listen. Remember, in one of the temptations, Satan took it to high temple and showed him the glory of the world and all that the devil wanted from him. But God said, Satan, I bow and I worship. That's all. And Satan said, I will give you the world and all the glory. But he said to Satan, I cannot worship you. It is only the Lord that man shall worship. Child of God, all the blings, bling, the shine, the glittering things. I'm not saying they are bad, but child of God, don't let the devil use those bling, all this world attraction to take you away from the Lord our God. Don't let them rob you of your salvation. Don't pursue the wealth in the world and miss your salvation and miss what God has planned and prepared for you. Because in times like this, you will think that, oh, I want to buy a brand new car, the latest one. I want to build a big, I want to have the biggest mansion. I want to be this. Listen to me. Those things, they are good. But child of God, you cannot get them at the expense of your word, of your salvation. Don't give up on God. Don't pursue those things and run into problems. There are people who are pursuing them. Satan said, I will give you wealth. I will give you this one. There are people, as I speak to you, that are entering into a covenant relationship with Satan, getting what we call blood money, internet money, robbing people because they just want to be, they want to belong. Child of God, don't forget. Ask yourself, what will it profit me at the end of the day if I gain all these things and then lose my soul at the end of the day? Ask yourself. And be encouraged by the word. Jesus Christ had the opportunity to possess the world. That was what Satan said to him, because Adam handed over the world, the glory of the world, everything that God gave to Adam to keep. Adam handed them over to Satan because he obeyed Satan. That the same thing Satan wanted to do to Jesus Christ. I said, Lord, Jesus, to obey me, just worship me, and I will give you this thing. But found the law that Jesus knew better. He knew better that it's only Jehovah which I worship. Child of God, worship not that creature, worship not that being, worship not that person, but worship the Lord alone. Worship the Most High God alone. I say with him, I hold on to him. Jesus is our high priest. Hallelujah. It's our high priest. He's our high priest. Make intercession for us. Hebrews chapter 7, verse 23. He said, and they truly were many priests because they were not suffered to continue by reason of death. But this man, because he continued ever, had an unchangeable priesthood. Wherefore he is able also to save them who? To save us. To the uttermost that come unto God by him. If you come to God by Jesus Christ, child of God, just able to save you. Hallelujah. Seeing he ever liveth. To make intercession for them. He's making intercession for us. Because he was in your shoe, he was in my shoe. He knew how he felt. He's able to tell the Father, please, I paid the price for him. What he's going through, I know it's very difficult. I suffer, I know the pains. I suffer the pain. I know what it means. I know how it feels. Make a way for him now. Remember, I've made a way for him. Remember, I paid a price for him to get out of this. So make sure, Father, get him out of this. Rebuke Satan on his behalf. Well, I defeated the devil on his behalf. Therefore, break the head of that devil that is warring against him. Set him free. And because I died to set him free, he's making intercession for you, for us. Don't give up. Don't give up. The Bible says he's able to save all to the uttermost as we come to God by him. Child of God. Listen, in all of this, you will come out stronger, better. God will bring you in a place you're able to comfort others. Jesus suffered it and is able to comfort us. Your experience also is going to make you a better comforter. Amen. God is going to make you a better comforter. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You're going to be a better encourager. Why? Because you have suffered it. You want to tell somebody, listen to me. Don't worry. God will see you out. I was in this situation before. I know how it feels. You understand my point? Like I said the other Sunday, I said, listen to me. A man can never comfort a woman that is in labor. You can't. Because what the woman is going through, you have never been pregnant. You can't even comfort a woman that you see we have big stomach, walking slowly and they're struggling, and then you are, how are you going to start? Well, you know what she's going through. Okay, maybe you have seen that she just with big stomach and you can't comfort the person. You don't even know what she's feeling. You don't even know how that load. I'm not talking about having big stomach because of food. You don't see my point. I'm talking about carrying a baby inside the womb. And she's just carrying that baby. And the baby, you know, not the baby of, not the fetus of a 2 weeks old or 3 weeks old. Maybe 7 months, 8 months, 9 months, and oh my God. You can only a woman, a mother that have been pregnant, that have gone through delivery, can know exactly what that baby is going through. Even if you are a woman and you have had your children without stress, that period of that heavy weight you are carrying, at least, you can't compare it to when you are just without any pregnancy. So you know what it means when you see a woman that is pregnant. A man can never know because men don't get pregnant. But listen to me, the fact that you are going through this, by the time you are out by the grace of God, I say you are out already in the name of Jesus Christ. When you are out, when you see somebody in this situation, you know how it feels. You know how to comfort that person. You know how to encourage the person. You know how to educate the person. God is preparing you to be a good encourager. Don't give up. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Child of God, listen to me. I say by the grace of God, you are out. Act from that unpleasant situation that you are right now in. Amen. I say you are out of it. The only thing I can tell you is that make sure you don't run out. Don't look for an escape for yourself. God is the one that will make a way of escape for you. Don't let the devil give you an alternative way to just come out quickly. Mm-mm. Okay? Just, I pray that you learn the lesson that God wants you to learn. Every lesson God wants you to learn, learn them. Amen. Hallelujah. Look at what we've been talking about. 2 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 3 and 5. Look at it. He said, blessed be God, even the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of mercies, and the God of all comfort. The God of all comfort, who comforted us in all our tribulation. May God come to comfort you in this present situation in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, that we may be able to comfort them which are in any trouble by the comfort wherewith we ourselves are comforted of God. You see that? For as the sufferings of Christ abound in us, so our consolation also abounded by Christ. God will comfort you. Jesus will comfort you. Holy Ghost will comfort you. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. And one of the things also you have to bear in mind, child of God, is that there is nothing you are going through that doesn't have an end. The fact that it has a beginning means also it has an end. If it has a beginning, it must expire one day. It must expire one day. If it has a manufacturing date, it will have an expiration date. You understand that? This problem will expire one day. Know it. It's not permanent. It's not permanent. It's temporary. The Bible says the things we see, they are temporary. They are not permanent. Hallelujah. Even this world is not permanent. This world will be destroyed one day. It has an expiry date according to the plan and purpose of God. So if this whole world has an expiry date, your challenges, your problem also have an expiry date. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. For now, listen to me, the expiry date will be determined by how you handle it. The expiry date and how you are going to come out of it will be determined by you, not by God again at this time. Listen to me. How you handle the problem will determine how the end is going to be. I say how you handle the problem is going to determine how the end is going to be. What do you want to see at the end? If you trust God and patiently wait for Him, and in Him, don't give up. Amen. Don't give up on Him, because He's not going to give up on you. Don't give up. Wait for Him. Let Him do what He's doing. Wait in Him. Okay? He will surely turn all things around for your own good. Remember the scripture says in Romans, He said, and all things shall work together for the good of those that love Him. Those who love God will stay in obedience. Because Jesus Christ says, you love me, keep my commandments. Keep God's commandments. Take in obedience to His word. Don't give up on God. God is turning things around for you. And they shall turn around for your own good, for your own glory, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. As He has promised not to forsake you nor leave you, don't forsake Him, don't leave Him. Amen. Amen. God, you rejoice in Him. Rejoice in the Lord your God. Rejoice in Him. If you believe God is working out something for you, give Him thanks. Be dancing. Be dancing before Him. Tell Him that, Lord, I know you are in control. So I'm not bothered by what I'm seeing. I'm not bothered by the information I'm hearing. I'm not bothered. All I know is that you are on the throne and you are working out something better for my life. And I give you praise. I give you glory. Hallelujah. It may be hurting you. What I'm going to be hurting, but child of God, listen to me. Don't consider it. Don't consider it. It may be painful, but don't consider it. People may be speaking to you to make you angry, to make you lose your cool, but child of God, block your ears to those negative things that are saying about you. Concentrate on your God. Keep looking unto Jesus. Hold on to Him. Let him see, because He's seeing. Let Him see that you are holding on to Him, because He's seeing what you are hearing. He's seeing the people who are mocking. He's seeing all the people that are warring against your life. He's seeing them. But child of God, just hold on to Him. Don't hold on to Him. He will bruise the head of those devils under your feet shortly. He's going to make a way for you so that you are not tempted above that which you are able to bear. Don't make a way of escape for yourself. Let God make the way of escape. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Child of God, you may not know that God is at work now. So don't look for that. But I'm not seeing, I'm not feeling as though God is working. No. He said, the scripture said, it is God who is at work in you. both to will and to do his own good pleasure. He said God is also is at work in you, but he has kept men, the sons of men, busy so that they will not know what he's doing from the beginning to the end. Child of God, even God will not tell you this is what I'm doing now. That guy will not tell you. All he's doing it by himself. He's doing it by his own power. But listen to me. The scripture says what? He maketh all things beautiful in his own time. Not your time, but believe that God is working out something beautiful in his own time. It is God that determines how many days Jesus Christ will spend under the earth in hell to satisfy the claim of justice that was contrary and against us. To pay the price that was due. It was God that determined, not Jesus Christ. But when it was time for the Lord to come out from hell and from the dead, when it was time, not 1 second more, not 1 second less, the Lord, God Almighty, by his Spirit, went to hell, quickened the Spirit of Jesus Christ, brought the Spirit back to the body in the grave, and brought her back to life. Child of God, not coming out. The Spirit of the Lord is walking in you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Not according to your own time. So don't be looking at your time. Don't look at your time. Don't believe God is at work. It may not be comfortable. You may not be happy, but encourage yourself. Rejoice in the Lord. Amen. It's a work of faith. That is our faith. That is the faith life. You have been called to live by faith. So live by belief God is working out things. Believe that the end is better. Your tomorrow is better than your yesterday. Even your today. Your tomorrow better than your today. Your end will be better than your beginning. Believe that God has spoken it, so shall it be in your life. Amen. So stay strong, child of God. My friend, stay strong. I say stay strong. Expect that miracle. Don't lose sight of the miracle. Don't lose sight of what you want to see. Amen. Because God is not going to leave you the way you were before you entered into the challenge. No, you are coming out better. When the gold, when the silver, when they go through the fire, they don't come back the way they used to be. They come out better. You are coming out better by the grace of God. As if you are coming out stronger by the grace of God. Hallelujah. So don't begin to pray now. Begin to thank the Lord. Begin to thank the Lord that you believe now that he's at work in you. And that he's working out things that at the end of the day, your life will be better than what it was before the crisis settled into your life. Begin to bless the Lord. Begin to bless the Lord. Begin to thank the Lord. Say, Lord, I believe your word. I believe your word. You didn't cause this pandemic, but you have allowed it. And I thank you because you are with me in it. I'm not alone because Lord, you said you will never leave nor forsake me. And that you are to walk in me, both to will and to do your own good pleasure. And that you will walk out things, make everything beautiful in your own time. Father, I surrender to you. Not my will, not my time, but let it be according to your time. Only give me grace to stand. Let me not fall. Give me grace to stand. Because God said to Paul, my grace is sufficient for you. May the sufficient grace of God come upon you so that, child of God, you will not become weary and fall by the wayside. May you receive that sufficient grace of God. Pray for yourself. And listen to me, my friend. If you have heard this message, you have not given your life to Jesus. Listen to me. Don't allow the devil to make mincemeat of you. Don't allow these problems and challenges see your end. Listen to me. May God give you grace to see the end of these challenges. So if you are not made God the Lord of your life, but because Jesus is a way out of problem, is the solution to every problem, is the answer to every question, is the only way to God, is the one through whom we can get saved. So ask him to come into your life right now. Believe that he's a sinner and ask him to come because you believe that he's a sinner and he died for you. Say with me, I pray for you. Say with me, Almighty God, thank you for your word I've heard today. I believe that Jesus came to this world to die for me. I believe he's there at your right hand making intercession for the children of God. and I'm here, oh God, to confess that I am a sinner. I came into this world as a sinner, and because I believe that Jesus is the Son who died for me, I'm asking Him to come into my life and save me, wash me with His blood, which He shed on the cross of Calvary. Jesus, Son of the living God, I receive you today as my Lord and my Savior. Be my Lord, be my Master, be my Savior, be my everything. I hand over my life, even the challenges I'm going through right now, I hand them over to you, that Lord, you will make a way for me. Make a way of escape for me. Let my end be better than my beginning. Let my tomorrow be better than my today. Have your way, my life, Lord. Have your way. I hold on to you. I hold on to you, my God. That Lord, you will turn this around for my good. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Father in heaven, I pray for everyone that heard this message that you will strengthen them. That Lord, you will encourage them by your Spirit. That Lord, you will strengthen them. Let your grace, oh God, to endure. The grace to stand and not to fall come upon them. And Lord, that nobody will be an unfinished product in your hand. But that Lord, you will make perfect that which concerns your children. That this problem and challenges they are going through will not see their end, but they will see the end of the challenges. And at the end of the day, they shall come out better and stronger and more glorious, oh God. That your name alone be glorified in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Child of God, receive grace to stand. I say, receive grace to stand. Every door the enemy shut against you, may the Lord open them. May the Lord hasten what He is doing. Because He said He is doing a quick work and He will cut it short in righteousness. May the Lord hasten what He is doing. In your life, may the Lord hasten it. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I speak peace upon your life. I speak life upon your business, upon your health. I speak life upon all that concerns you. That which was dead or is nearing to die, I command you to receive life and come up alive in Jesus' mighty name. That sickness, the Lord destroyed it because Jesus took your infirmity, for your sickness and your disease. By His stripes, you have been healed. He was made poor that you might be rich. As the Lord is making intercession for you, child of God, receive your miracle. Receive your blessing. Lay hold upon that miracle and thank God that you have received it. And so it shall come to pass in your life. Father, Lord, I say thank you. Take all the glory and all the honor, Lord, for all you have done for us today. Thank you for encouraging your son, your daughter. Thank you for the way you have made. Thank you, Lord, for the glorious end that you have given to us all. In Jesus' mighty name, I pray. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I believe you have been blessed. Hallelujah. I have been blessed. So I look forward to hearing from you. I look forward to hearing from you. Share your testimony with us. Okay? Let us know that God is God Almighty. Our God is a God who never fails. Our God is faithful and covenant-keeping God. Whatever He has promised to do, He shall be bring them to pass. Hallelujah. Because none of His words shall return to Him void. As my prayer, the promise of God will not return to God void, but that accomplishing, fulfilling that which is meant to accomplish in your life. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. So, thank you very much for connecting with us today. I look forward to seeing you again. Don't forget, child of God, don't forget. If God has blessed you, God has blessed you. Okay? Don't forget. Pay your tithe to Him. That's one of the ways to believe that God is the one sustaining you. Abraham had one child. And that same one child, God said to him, go and sacrifice the child. Amen. Don't say because things are not easy. If God has blessed you, if God gives you, if you make profit in your business, or God, you are a salary earner and you have earned your salary, or somebody gave a gift, because not everybody receives gifts. Even somebody gives you a gift, it's not because they look at your face, no. It's the grace of God that made them to give. So give God one tenth of it. That's what belongs to God. Amen. Let God know that your life depends on Him and not on that gift. Your life does not depend on your salary, it doesn't depend on your business. Your life depends on Him. So give God that will belong to Him and let Him come to make way for you. Amen. Now, don't forget, don't say because you are not coming to church, you will not give offering, or you will not take part in the things God is doing. So please, anytime you got your tithes and then you want to give your offering, that the church account there, that the church account there. So just make sure you transfer your, you do your transfer to the church account, and God will bless you for being part of what He's doing. Amen. God will make sure that there's food in your heart, because you're also making sure there's food in the house of God. That's when to do the work of the kingdom of our God. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. So the message shared with your God once again. Let go feel and let go hear that God is on the throne. Amen. He will not abandon us. So I look forward to seeing you again on Sunday. Coming Sunday by 9 o'clock. By the grace of God, we're going to be looking at something different. And on Wednesday by 7 p.m., we'll have our midweek service. Please, we are talking about something very important. Make sure you connect to that. That message is very, very important. You will encourage. It will be a blessing to you, child of God. So make sure Wednesday, 7 p.m., you are connected with us online, or we're coming online. Amen. And this coming Friday is the last Friday of the month of July. We are going to be having our all-night meeting, what you call the vigil, okay? Night of God's visitation. We trust that God will visit us. You know, He will open His ears, He will hear our prayers, okay? And He will grant our desire. So I look forward to seeing you again online by 12 p.m. It's 12 p.m., 12 a.m., 12 midnight, that's 12 a.m. Okay, 12 midnight, 12 a.m. Okay, so I look forward to seeing you there. Let us come and let us pray. Hallelujah. Let us lift up our voice unto the Lord, and God will hear from heaven and do for us that which we desire from Him. Hallelujah. God bless you. I remain your pastor, Pastor Newton Denila, speaking from Grace One Minute House of Favor. Hallelujah. Amen. May the grace of God be multiplied upon you. May the light of God going to shine upon you. May your life become better with each passing day. And the work God has started to do, may He bring to perfect completion in your life. Say bless, and see you a better person tomorrow. In Jesus' name.